Hi, I'm Tim Shields, and I'm going to show you what depth of field is, what it does, and why you need to know how to use depth of field so that your photos will be super sharp and they won't be blurry. Let me show you exactly what depth of field is and how you can use it to get super sharp photos. Take a look at the top here. So this is you right here, and this is your camera on a tripod. This over here is your friend, and you want to take a photo of your friend. And behind your friend is a lake. Yes, this is a lake. And there's some guy in a canoe on the lake. And way in the background, there are these mountains. So this is where depth of field comes into play. So let's say for the first photo, you want to have the entire scene as being sharp and in focus. And so you want these mountains sharp, you want the lake sharp, and you want your friend to be sharp. So for this scenario, we're going to be talking about a long depth of field. So the depth of field will start here, it's going to end all the way back over here, and all of this distance from here all the way over to here is representing a long depth of field. So just see if I can get my pen to work here. Oh, it's making lines where I don't want it to work. There we go. Long. Not my most impressive printing. So we want a long depth of field. How do we do that? Well, we need to take control of our camera. You have to get your camera out of auto mode, but you don't necessarily need to be in full manual where everything is confusing. There's kind of a hybrid setting, a little bit of auto and a little bit of manual, and it's called aperture priority. So if you want a long depth of field, you want to set your aperture for a value of something that is kind of a high number, like f16. I don't recommend going above f16 because some problems happen to the quality of your photo overall. But if you set your aperture for f16 and your camera is in aperture priority mode, then you will most likely be able to get everything from the foreground. This area here is the foreground, and this area here is the background. So you will be able to get everything from the foreground to the background all in focus, which is what you want for this scenario. And let me show you kind of an example of what this looks like. So if I click on here and click on this photo here. So here's a picture of Moraine Lake, and you see these rocks down here in the foreground. This is our foreground. This is all super sharp. And here's our background back here. This is all also super sharp. And that's because I used an aperture number of something like f16, and I was using aperture priority. So I have a long depth of field. Now, let's take a look at another scenario where you want a short depth of field. So here is a macro photo, and where short depth of field comes into play, look at the butterfly here and the flower. It's all super sharp. And this whole background area here, it's totally out of focus, completely blown out. And why you would want this is because it puts the viewer's eye, the viewer's focus only on the main subject. So you are creating contrast through focus. Let's look at one other example, and this is where having a short depth of field is really effective, and it's with portraits or people shots. So if you look at the face of my little girl when she still was a little girl, her face is completely in focus, but look at this beautiful background back here, completely soft. So there's no distractions, there's no clutter, and we're only looking at the main subject's face. This is a beautiful technique. Now, how did we get to this point? It's because I was using an aperture setting or an f-stop. I had a special lens on. It was f1.8, I think, for this. It was a portrait lens, 50 millimeter f1.8, and that's how I got this look. So let's take a look back at our outdoor scenario. And so for this scenario, we want the background of the depth of field to be essentially right here, and we want the foreground to be essentially right here. So now our depth of field is very short that we want. We only want it just in front of the subject and just in front of the background, or sorry, just behind the subject. We want the focus point to be ending here. So how do we get that? we go to the smallest f-stop value that we have on our lens, which can be f2.8, it may be f3.5, it just depends on which lens that you have. And if you are really wanting to kind of magnify that effect, then at the same time, you want to zoom in your lens. Because when you zoom in your lens to the maximum zoom, and at the same time, you have your smallest f-stop value, then you will get the maximum effect that you're looking for of having something in focus here with the background being blurry. So that is the primer on depth of field. Now, let me go back to the TIM view here. There is the TIM view. So keeping in mind that when your camera is in aperture priority, you will have that easy ability to set the aperture. You can set it for a very small number, and that's going to give you the shortest possible depth of field. Or you can set your aperture for a very high number, and it will give you the longest possible depth of field. Now, the biggest complaint that I hear from photographers, the biggest question that they have is, how do I get sharp photos? And this is one of the two ways. The first way to get sharp photos is to make sure that you are taking control of depth of field. And the second way is through your shutter speed. But that's a conversation for another lesson. We're talking about the first half of the equation, which is depth of field. Now, if you want to literally take your photography to the point where you are creating tack sharp magazine quality photos that have the option of even winning photography awards, like taking award-winning photos, then I want to invite you to take my free online web class. This free online web class, I introduce you to my four-step system. And there are literally just four steps that you need to follow to be taking your own award-winning photos. So if you go to photographyacademy.com, you'll see there is a blue button right here. You'll notice that our entire mandate is that we help photographers take award-winning photos through the Photography Transformation four-step system. So I have a free one-hour web class. All you need to do is put in your first name, put in your email address, click the pink button, and you will be watching the web class right away. If you give me 1 hour of your time, I will give you my absolute best tips and tricks so that you can be taking your own tack-sharp award-winning photos. So photographyacademy.com, there's the button. And I'll see you inside the free web class.